my pleasure to introduce for our first piece, Please Rise for the Star Spangled Banner, conducted by our very own Brian Kim.
Maestro!
Maestro! Okay, it is so great to see all of you here this evening. I see some people looking for seats. Can you maybe raise your hand if there's an empty seat near you? We'll look around, there's plenty of seats. No reason for anyone to stand. Please sit back and enjoy yourself tonight. We want you to find a seat. Okay, well, I'm Anissa Arnold, the Director of Fine and Performing Arts. I know all of you know me already. It is so great to see you tonight at our first Herricks High School concert for winter 2022. So great to see you. And thank you to Herricks Middle School for allowing us to utilize this beautiful space. Next time we see you, we'll hopefully be in our brand new space. So this program, you will be seeing and hearing 210 powerful string players. Can we give them all a round of applause? You're not only going to hear them in their individual groups, you're going to hear them all together. So brace yourself for a fabulous evening. Before we start, I just want to recognize some special friends who are here with us tonight. First, the Vice President of the Board of Education, Henry Zanetti. Our Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Tony Sinanis. And our Herricks High School principal, Ms. Joan Keegan. It is now my pleasure to turn over the microphone to our wonderful conductor, director, Ms. Catherine Burke. Enjoy the concert.
Keep that applause going for our concertmaster, Joel Tan. They have come so far and they sound so good. So you're gonna clap for them a lot, but that was Carmen. You probably know most of those tunes. It's one of the most famous operas of all time, and it's three of the most famous segments from it. In fact, if you walk around the halls of Herricks High School long enough, you'll hear my cello section down here just nonstop playing the habanera. So it's pervasive in our culture. Hope you enjoyed it. Our next piece is a trio feature of sorts. We have two violin soloists, our first band, Joel Tan and Julia Lamb, Adam Chu on continuo. And you probably heard this one as well. It's from Vivaldi's Four Seasons. The one we hear the most is spring. But you may have noticed, it is not spring, it is winter. So we're gonna play winter. Enjoy. Thank you. Not too shabby. Let's give another round of applause for our soloist. This is a big audience. I've been told that I'm not supposed to use the word slay anymore because it's like outdated, but this is a big audience you just slayed in front of, so don't groan at me. You're all groaning at me. The Freshman Orchestra has one more piece for you tonight. It's the Dvorak Allegretto from Symphony No. 8, and it's absolutely beautiful. We hope you enjoy. Thank you. Now we're going to ask, that's so loud, sorry, that you bear with us. We're having 74 students exit the stage and 100 and something come on. We're going to do it as fast as physically possible. So thank you. Tight. While they are coming so beautifully and quietly on stage, thank you, my students, I want to say a couple of things that I just want to make sure that I don't forget. The first is I have a couple of absolutely phenomenal teachers here tonight chaperoning, helping me, and I would love to give all three of them a round of applause, so hold your applause until all three. Mr. Jeff Stone, Mrs. Eva Viavatni, and Ms. Alexis Camisa, our high school art teacher and our middle school music teachers. They helped me with everything from tuning students. Mr. Stone has played a huge role in helping to prepare the students for their music, so I thank him for that. And hanging string lights. So they do it all. Part of the reason that I love this concert so much, and it's probably my favorite night of the year, is because you get to see what we call in the educational realm vertical integration, which sounds like a buzzword, but it's a real thing. You get to see the entire string program at the high school from the time they're in ninth grade to the time they're in 12th grade. So you just saw our fabulous ninth graders. This is Concert Orchestra, and it's made up of 10 through 12th graders. When I first started at Herricks, this group had 40-something students in it, and now you're looking at, I forget the exact number, but it is well over 100. So thank you for your patience while we got well over 100 students on stage. But you did a good job with that set change. Yeah, give yourselves a round of applause. I'm going to ask that you bear with us. I think it's very important to teach every orchestra not only how to play, but how you should look when you start a concert. So even though we've already seen me walk out, we're going to do it again every time so that every single orchestra gets the experience. But you don't have to clap for me again if you don't want to, because I know it's gratuitous, but thank you. But I do want you to clap for our concertmaster, Chloe King. as fast and effervescent and beautiful as that Haydn symphony was, we're going to take it in a totally different direction with the romance from Rachmaninoff's Second Symphony. One of, in my opinion, the most beautiful melodies of all time. And I think the violas wanted me to say that when we think about this piece, we usually think about a piece just starting. You know, you hear me sniff because I'm congested, and then we start. But this piece sort of, it's almost like it's already going, and we're just sort of joining in to it. And I hope you get that feeling, that the music's just always going, and we just kind of hop on and go. It's very beautiful. Enjoy.
Thank you.
going back to fun and fast, this is a klezmer tune called Der Heiser Bulgar, and it's just really fun, and we hope you enjoy. Give another big round of applause for Concert Orchestra. I'm gonna walk down the stairs and have to concentrate or I'm gonna fall. We finally turn our attention to these floor dwellers who've been sitting here so patiently this whole time. So I just wanna say a quick word about the chamber orchestra. This is the chamber orchestra. And for those of you who are parents and family members of chamber orchestra students, you have heard this before in October. And we don't usually redo pieces, but this is an unusual year because the chamber orchestra has been accepted to compete at the ASTA, American String Teachers Association, National Orchestra Festival, which is the biggest national competition. National competition approaching, you approach it slightly differently, and that competition will be happening in March. So we did about half of our program music in our October concert, and we'll do the second half of that music in February. It's not quite ready yet, but But I thought it'd be great, especially for those of you who haven't heard them do this, to just see like what the possibilities are and what it looks like when you're getting ready for a national competition pretty intensely. So these students have been working so hard. We're going to play Shostakovich for you. And we're going to do only one movement, which is very short. But because it's so short, we're going to give you just a little bit of a slow intro into it from the first movement into the second. It's the closest thing I've ever experienced to heavy metal music played on string instruments. So we hope you enjoy, and please give a round of applause to our concertmaster, Kaylee Love.
Thank you.
situated, it's a great time. If you've got that little concert gram card to write down for your student what your favorite piece was and maybe a little nice message to them, we're gonna collect them, the ushers will collect them at the door, and then I can pass them out later in the week. It means more than you think. Your high schoolers want you to think that they are unaffected by your presence here, but they're not. They're thrilled. They absolutely love it, and they're thrilled, and the praise from you means the world. So if you have a pen or a pencil or you need to borrow one, please do fill that card out and drop it at the basket on your way out. If you're unsure where to put it, just make a pile and we'll find them. But thank you so much for that. Okay, here's our grand finale. Might not work, but if it does, it'll be